Hi, this is Shad with lovetocode.com. In this video, we will explore the user interface in Eclipse. We will examine windows, menus, videos, and perspectives. So let's get started. When you launch the Eclipse application, you'll see a screen that is similar to this. This is the general layout of Eclipse when you use it for Java development. The window has three main sections. On the left-hand side is the Package Explorer. In the center is the main window, and at the bottom are additional views for console output, problems, and other items. Moving back to the Package Explorer view, you can use this to keep track of multiple projects. You can open the projects by simply expanding the folders. So here I'll have the samples project. I'll expand the source directory, and there's a package called samples. And then here we have two Java files, Driver.java and Passwordutils. You can expand each one of those, and you'll see a list of methods and fields for those classes. Here I'll take a look at the Generate Password method. I can double-click it, and I'll see the source code in the main editor window. So now that we have the method opened, we can view the code, scroll through, and look at all the other code. If you need to get a larger view of your screen, you can simply double-click the tab at the top. This will maximize the window, just to give you more real estate to play around with your code. And then to go back to the regular view, you just double-click one more time, and it'll pull it up. The Eclipse editor also has another feature that's very useful. You can hover over a method, and it'll actually bring up the Java doc for that method, so that's the documentation. So here we'll see the documentation for the append method. Also at the bottom there's a tab called Java doc. So when you select one of the methods, you'll see it right here instead of having to wait for the pop-up or worry about the pop-up moving away. So very useful feature. If you have any problems with your code, say for example I have a typo on the method name, and it'll bring up a red X and also a red squiggly to show you there's an error. So you can hover over it, it'll give you the error right there on the screen. Also, you can move to this Problems tab at the bottom, and it'll give you a list of all the errors so you can work through them accordingly. So in this example, I'll just go ahead and fix the error message, and I'm ready to go. And the error message goes away at the bottom. When you run your application, at the bottom of the screen, you'll see the console output. So I'll simply run the app by saying run as Java application. And at the bottom, there's a new tab that just showed up, console output. So this is the output of your application. You can double click it to get a much larger view of it. Double click again to go back to the original view. And when you're done or you want to clear out this window, you simply hit the X and that'll clear it out. When you run the application one more time, you'll see the same output there at the bottom with the results of your program. And if you accidentally happen to close your console window by mistake by maybe hitting the X on it, then you can always get back to that console view by going to Window, Show View, Console. And that'll give you the console window back at the original location. Now what I'll do is I'll show you the outline view. The outline view is an alternative way of looking at a Java class to get a list of the fields and the methods. You can view the outline view by going to Window, Show View, and Outline. And this will bring up the outline view. So it's over on the right-hand side. So it has the class, list of fields, and the list of methods. One really cool thing about Eclipse is that you can customize the layout of your different views. So instead of having the outline view over on the far right hand side, it would be nice if it's over on the left side of the window. So I can simply grab the tab title and move it on over to the left hand side. So now I have the outline view at the top and the package explorer at the bottom. Now I like for these to show up side by side, so I can grab this tab and just drag it right next to package explorer. And there you have it. So you can go back and forth between them. And say, for example, I'd like to take outline and move it to the bottom, just drag and drop over here to the bottom. And now I have the outline view. So if you get in a certain weird state, like say, for example, I grab this and just move it to the middle, and things are kind of not the way I would like, you can always reset it back to its original view. So Eclipse has this idea of a perspective. So a perspective is like a default layout for a given scenario. So here we're using the Java perspective. So I can simply tell Eclipse to reset the Java perspective. I can do that by going to Window and saying Reset Perspective. This will prompt me if I want to reset. I'll say yes, and then I'll put it back in the original layout. Well, that's about it. I covered the most common user interface features in Eclipse. Feel free to explore the user interface on your own. Remember, you can't break anything. If you get things out of whack, just reset the perspective. Okay, so let's go ahead and wrap up. So in this section, we explored the Eclipse user interface. We covered windows, menus, views, and perspectives. Please subscribe to our channel to view more videos in Eclipse and Java. Also, visit our website, lovetocode.com, to download Java source code.